Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Armin, and this is the first project-based tutorial on COMSOL. In this video, I will demonstrate how to model a monopole sound source and a barrier in front of it. Here we have a small barrier. I will click on play and see the effect of barrier height on the source pattern. Also, we can see the stress and deformation of the barrier because it is flexible. Here we can change the frequency of the sound source and the height of the barrier. We need two physics, solid mechanics and pressure acoustic, so it is a multiphysics model. Please make sure to watch the entire video to get a full understanding. Let's get started. I'm going to click on the model wizard. The model is two-dimensional. So I'm going to click on 2D. We need pressure acoustics because we want to perform an acoustic analysis. When we click on the study, it will take us to the study window. In study, I will select frequency domain and click on done. Everything is okay. It's time to create geometry. There are three ways to create a geometry. By right-clicking on geometry and selecting the desired shape, selecting from the geometry tab or from the sketch tab. I'm going to select the rectangle from the sketch tab and draw an optional rectangle. Here we can specify position and dimensions of rectangle. I'm going to delete it and create a rectangle from geometry tab. I will specify 6 and 5 meters. The corner of the rectangle is positioned at the origin of the coordinate system. As you can see, the results are the same. We can use zoom extents to view the geometry better. By selecting the geometry and clicking on Build All, the rectangle lines will become solid. We need a monopole sound source, so I will define a point in the domain. I will specify 1.5 and z.5 meters. This is the location of the sound source. The geometry is ready. It's time to add material. By right-clicking on material and selecting Add Material from Library, we can select air for the domain. As you see, only density and speed of sound are used in pressure acoustics. It's time to add a sound source. In the Physics tab, we can add our desired conditions. There are all the sound source types and points. I need a monopole source that is equal to a speaker. This is a point source, so we can only select points. I will select point 1. Here we can choose any type of sound source. I will select power and specify as L1. All of the boundaries are rigid by default. In this step, I leave it and go to study. Element size depends on the maximum frequency. So I will add frequency interval at first. Here we can add our desired frequency, or by clicking on range, we can add an interval. Here we can enter the minimum, step size, and maximum frequency range. I want to add a 1/3 octave frequency, So, I will change the step to ISO. I'm going to enter minimum and maximum frequency and octave bands will be created automatically. As you see, the maximum element size is defined from the study. Now we can generate mesh by clicking on Build All. Here we can change the element size, which I leave as the default. Finally, I will click on Compute and wait until finishing the solution. After the solution, we can see acoustic pressure and sound pressure level. Also, we can change the frequency from the parameter value. As I said, this is a rigid boundaries domain like a rigid box. I want to model a free field sound like a sound source in the environment. There are several boundary conditions for modeling a free field domain. In this example, I will use a perfectly matched boundary. We can find it from the context menu or in the physics tab. I will select four edges of domain. Geometry is not a circle, so I will change the attenuation direction from radial to normal. Now I will click on Compute again. In the graphics window, we can see the monopole sound pattern. Also, we can see sound pressure level. Now I want to create a barrier. I will select a rectangle from the context menu and adjust its location. First, I assume that the barrier is rigid. So I will delete it with the difference tool. After changing the geometry, we have to check all of the boundary conditions. I have to deselect the barrier from perfectly matched boundaries. Now the barrier's walls are rigid. I'm going to generate mesh again and click on Compute. This is the acoustic pressure plot, and also, we can see the sound pressure level that the barrier has blocked the sound wave. In this step, I will specify a parameter for the height of the barrier. By using parameters, we can determine the acoustic pressure and sound pressure level in relation to the height of the barrier. We need to define a parameter, such as Y0. Please note that there are several predefined names in COMSOL, such as X and Y, that we cannot use as parameters. Therefore, I will enter 01 for Y0 and write Y0 in the height of rectangle 2. Then, I will enable the parametric sweep in study 1 and add Y0. we can add a range for the solution. The value of y0 in the parameters window is 0,1, and this range of the parametric sweep is replaced by 0,1. The model is now ready, and I will click on Compute and wait until the solution finishes. After the solution, two plots have been added that display the parametric sweep results. Here we have two parameter values, y0 and frequency. We can change the parameter value to switch between barrier height and frequency. Then we can go to the previous and next graph by clicking on the arrow icons. I want to create an animation, so I will click on the animation. And in loop over, I will select Y0. Also, I'd like to see the sound pressure graph at 500 Hz. I will change the number of frames to all, and then click on Show Frame to observe all the results of the acoustic pressure at a specific frequency. By clicking on the play icon in the graphics window, we can view the barrier height animation at 500 Hz. The first part of the tutorial is over. In the second part, I will demonstrate how to model a flexible barrier. Thank you for watching. And if you found this helpful, please like and subscribe to my channel.